Good morning, YouTube. It's your girl, Tori. It is like 6 o'clock in the morning and I am up and at it. I am on my treadmill this morning and I want you all to get up with me. Come on, get up, get up, get up. Let's get moving. I'm about to do a workout on my treadmill and I am going to record the whole thing so that you can see what I'm doing. I am going to go ahead and get started. Come on, get up. You all have got to get up. Let's get moving. Don't just watch me. I need you to get up and I need you to move. I need you to put in some work. All right, so I'm going to do a mile on, I'm going to start on an incline of 5. And I'm going to start out on a speed of 2.5. Alright, so I'm at a speed of 2.5. I hope that y'all are getting up right now. Don't just watch me. I need you to get up and I need you to move with me. That's the whole purpose of this. I want you to move with me. I'm going to get winded as we go, but that's okay. That's all a part of keeping it real. I'm not a robot. You know, I get tired. I'm going to stop breathing heavy. But I hope that you are finding some kind of motivation in this to get up off of your own couch, to get up out of your own bed at 6 o'clock in the morning. I did not feel like getting up this morning. I fought it. I said, well, I'll get up at 5:30 and I will get started. And 5:30 turned into like 5:55. Because of course, you know, I had to go to YouTube. I had to check to see if, I had to see what was going on YouTube with my channel. So I do want to thank those of you who are looking at my videos. These kind of things, you know, I'm realistic, they do take off slow. But, you know, if you don't start, if you don't do it, it'll never happen. So, you know, my thing is just start. So, yeah, I definitely love doing this. I love trying to help other people in the process of helping myself. And I think that's important, you know, along our journeys of life, to motivate other people, even if it's just one. You know, I'm not saying that I'm going to change the whole world, but if you can just help one person, or a couple of people, or a few people, it's worth it. So, I've only gone a tenth of a mile. And it is, but it feels good. It just feels good to know that you're working your body, that you got up out of bed, and that you're doing something good for yourself. I don't want my birthday to come. This is going to be chapter 41 for me. And we cannot take days for granted. We cannot take years for granted. We cannot even take minutes for granted anymore because nothing is promised to us. And so when I think about, you know, my life and how thankful and how grateful, I'm going to stop this for a second because I just want to make sure that my volume is up. It would suck to have gone through all of that and you all not be able to hear me. Let me go back to 2.5. You know, when we think about life and everything, it is really, we can't take anything for granted. And so, for as long as I can be useful, be active, and, and keep myself in shape the best that I can, I'm going to do that. Because it's so easy to get to where you can't do it. I remember, I'm going to take this up a notch because I don't want to be all morning doing this mile. But, back to what I was saying. We can't take anything for granted as far as staying active. And I remember times in my life where I would get to a point where I just wouldn't work out. And then when you go back to doing it, it's that much harder. It's like starting over. So, it's something that you just kind of have to keep. You have to keep up with it. And the reward for me, of course it's about a number on the scale. I think anybody would be fibbing if they said, I don't care what the scale said. We do, but even more so for me, it's about how my clothes fit me. How I look in my clothes, that kind of thing. That is the reward for me. So, that is why I don't mind seeing you sweat this morning. I don't mind you seeing me get winded, on this treadmill. This is good. This is good stuff. So, again, I hope that you all find some motivation in this, in me doing this. I would like for you to, if by any chance this video is helping you in any way, don't forget to like the video. Leave me a comment. If you see the comment section down below, leave me a comment. I'm hot. It is getting so hot. I do have a fan on my treadmill, so I'm gonna turn it on low. So if you hear anything, it's my fan. Just giving me a little bit of relief. But the feeling of sweating out toxins out of your body, there's nothing like that either. Because this is all really good stuff. It's kind of in the moment it may be uncomfortable, but when like 6:23 to 6:24 when that comes, you're gonna think yourself that you did this. And then I am going to go, I'm not gonna have breakfast this morning. I'm really not hungry. And I'll have my lunch today around probably 1 or so. This depends on what my schedule says at work. But I'll have my lunch then. And my lunch will consist of protein. So I'll probably have me a burger today with no bun. I'll have some cheese on it, that kind of thing, and I may do a veggie. Just depending on what I have in my fridge. That's what I'll do for lunch today. And I found that when you eat like that, you don't get hungry as quick. It really holds you over. So, if you haven't tried it, you should try it. It's a really good way of curbing your appetite. Because I found that whenever I eat bread or even something sweet, it triggers something in your mind and your body to where you crave it. If you eat one piece of candy, that's why chips, they say you can't eat this one.
they're not lying. You cannot eat this one because your mind always wants more. So, and those are the things that make you angry. If your body is like mine, or most people, you eat things like chips and cake and candy, and your body's going to keep craving. And I love all of those things, so, you know, don't look at me and think I'm some superhero because I'm cutting those things out. I'm just cutting them out because I see results. You know, I see results. So, when you see results, you kind of push those things to the side. And don't be fooled by things that look healthy, or don't be fooled by things that you say, well, I'll get this for a snack, and I'll only eat a little bit of it, and that will mess you up. I did that. I got these pralines, and they were coated, you know, coated, I don't know, whatever, piece of walnut, finger walnut, and they had the sweet coating on them. And the serving was like 12 carbs for 8. So I was like, well, if I go all day and I don't have any carbs, and I just have a handful of those, that's only 12 carbs for the day. Which, in one of my previous videos, I told you I'm trying to stay between 20 and 30-ish. So it's not that I don't eat any carbs, I'm just trying to keep them low. So, I said with those nuts, I said, well, if I just eat a handful, okay. So I had that, and I had a bar, well, a piece of like 92% chocolate, which is bitter as all get out. So, of course, I needed the praline to offset the bitter chocolate. It was great together. But what did I do? I kept eating and kept eating and kept eating. If I had just had that one piece of bitter chocolate, I probably would have been done. But in my mind, I would have had chocolate. But I kept eating those great pralines with the chocolate, so it kind of didn't make sense. So I'm giving the rest of those to my husband because they just trigger something in me to make me want sweets more. And I don't want to get off, I don't want to get off track. And then on Sunday, I had, and this is just me being transparent because I don't want anybody to think that I'm starting this journey and from, you know, day one up until November 4th that I'm not going to make mistakes. So on Sunday, we decided to have Chinese. And that was a challenge because I'm like, well, you know, now I need to write. And I don't want to eat anything that's heavily breaded. So there went the General Tso's chicken or, you know, anything like that. So the healthiest or the best option, none of it's healthy. Don't get fooled into that. I don't even think their veggies are healthy. Just my opinion. But anyway, the best option for me ended up being eggs and yolk with no rice. Okay, so I got that, but it is so heavily deep fried that when I ate it, I mean, I love it. I love it. So I said, okay, I'm only going to have a half a patty. So I ate the half a patty, and I never get the gravy on it. I always get General Tso's sauce on the side. So I said, well, I'm not going to get the gravy on it. I never do. I'm going to get the General Tso's sauce, which sauces are loaded with carbs, by the way. And I said, I'm not going to pour it on it. I'm going to dip it. I did okay with that. I didn't use much. But what did it do? It triggered something in me to want to continue to eat foods like that. that I probably won't. I told my husband, I said, I don't even feel like I want to eat things like that because they just make me want to eat more. You know, do you want things to start to sweat? This is a good workout. I'm still on an incline of 5. And I'm at, let's see where I am. I'm at 16th of a mile, so I'm getting there. I'm not going to take the incline up simply because I'm talking to you guys. But normally I would put it on 10 because I'm not saying anything. But I need this oxygen. So if I put it on 10, I'm going to be back here on the floor somewhere. But I feel like this is a really good workout. This is Tori time for real with you guys. So, and I do try to get my upper body workout with my arms. Don't leave them out. This is really a total body workout. You may not feel like it, but it is. You're working your total body. So, what do y'all think about the Popeye's chicken sandwich? Have you tried it? It's crazy. I haven't tried it. Because, and I probably would have, if I was not doing this, I would have tried it. But, I knew that, you know, the chicken itself was heavily breaded. There's the bun. So I would have, that would have really blown my mind, you know, my mindset. I would have been wanting another one, and I look at food like that and I gain weight, so I left it alone. But this morning, I heard they're sold out. How do you sell out of chicken sandwiches? I mean, that's crazy. How do you sell out? So I don't know what it is about that chicken sandwich. I'm convinced that it can't be that good. It cannot be that good. But the thing about it is whenever anybody hypes something up, then everybody wants to try it. Regardless of what it tastes like, looks like, you hype it up, and the next person is going to want to try it. So good for Popeyes. I mean, the advertising that people have done has helped them. They could have never advertised like that. Never. So people and word of mouth really, you know, gets things out there. So, I don't know if y'all can hear my music because I'm listening to, this is my husband's playlist. I'm listening to Busta Rhymes. And I love Busta Rhymes. His music is just, it'll take you there. I am going to bump this up to a speed. I bumped it up to 2.9. Just because, like I said, I'm not trying to make this video too much longer. And it's just good practice to talk and walk, because it builds your heart muscle, strengthens your heart muscles. I'm gradually going to work my way up to jogging. I can jog for about 5 minutes, and then I have to stop. I had to get there. But like I said, if I try and jog and talk, I'm going to be back on the floor. Y'all are going to be like, where'd she go? Because I can't do all that yet. But this sweat feels really good rolling down my back, because I know that I'm doing something right. I don't know if you can see it or not, but I'm hot. So, anyway, like I said, I hope that y'all are getting your shoes on to get on your treadmill, or getting your shoes on to go outside and walk, or just getting up to walk around your house inside. You can't even do it inside. Walking is walking. You know, don't not do do it because you don't have something. Use what you have until you get what you need. Just use what you have. No more excuses. No more excuses. I need Mary J. Blige. I need that song on repeat. No more excuses. I think it's no more excuses. No more drama. No more something. But it all ties together. None of that. Just do it. Get up. Just do it. And Nike made the best slogan when they said that. And I have on Nike shoes. You can't see them. But just do it. That's what I had to do this morning. Like I said, I was laying there in the bed, and I was going to get up at 5:30. I was still on my phone. And then the longer I laid there, I said, well, I'm never getting anything done laying in the bed. So I just had to, the first step was to roll out. Sit up first. And then I just had to get up and just do it. Alright, so I am at 20 minutes. I'm at 9/10 of a mile. And that's not terrible for walking and talking. For me, it's not. Of course, some of you could do this in half the time. But again, like I said in my last video, don't compare yourself to anyone else. So if you do this and it takes you 30 minutes or it takes you 40 minutes, it doesn't matter how long it takes you. What matters is that you have done it for you. It does not matter the time. It just matters that you're setting your mind to say, I'm just going to do it. You know, I'm just going to get started. I'm just going to do the thing. That is important. I have truly enjoyed this time with you guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. I never really realized it, but I am a talker. One thing I really don't like to do is to stand in front of physical people, but I'm working on that. You know, we all have things that we have to work on, and for me, that's one of them. But this is great. I love you guys. I hope that you have enjoyed this. I hope it has inspired you. I just reached 1 mile, so I'm going to drop this down to 1. I hope that this has motivated, inspired someone. Somebody, somewhere, to get up off of your couch, out of your bed, out of your car, and do what it is that you need to do. Again, I love you guys. Leave me comments. You can hit me up on Facebook, Instagram, wherever you can find me. Leave me your comments, your questions, whatever it may be. Until next time, dream big.